Since I learned about the SignWriting notation system for sign language, I had this idea to build an automatic transcription system that takes a video and outputs SignWriting. Instead of using a sequence of frames or poses, we want a single discrete token per sign regardless of the sign language.
Imagine we had a perfect 3D pose estimation system. We could understand the shape of everything in every single frame, like here the face and the hand, and then combine these with the movement patterns to get single tokens per sign. But unfortunately, we don't currently have perfect 3D pose estimation systems. I think that with the currently available tools, we can get some kind of approximation. We'll see how far we can get in this video. It's been a few hours when I repurposed the sign language detection app I previously built. Right now, it's using holistic pose estimation and drawing it on screen, and I added the feature to show and hide layers, so we can see just the pose for just me.
2 weeks later.
It's been a couple weeks where I didn't work on this on camera, but I did get some nice progress. The first thing is that now we have sign writing. We can draw a sign writing layer and let's maybe hide the rest, where we can see my face, my shoulder line, and a box for every hand. One interesting feature that sign writing has is that things don't change with regarding to their actual size. So if my hand is farther away from the camera or closer to the camera, the hand symbol will stay the same size. That's same for the face. If I get closer or farther away, the face symbol will stay the same size. Right now, I'm drawing all of them proportionally to the shoulder width. So if I get farther away from the camera, everything does get smaller, but with the same proportion for everything. Next, we want to talk about the handshapes. Instead of just using the box to represent the fist, we want this sign writing transcription system to be able to understand what is the current handshape. Let's take, for example, this handshape. Out of the 261 available handshapes in sign writing, this looks like the hand-fist little index thumb shape, also more commonly known as the I love you hand. This is my left hand, so we want to look at the bottom part of this chart. Then, this seems to be parallel to the wall plane, so we'll take the first three columns. Next, the hand is facing outwards, where the back of the hand is facing the signer, so we'll choose the third column. And finally, we'll choose the last row, as the rotation of the hand is 45 degrees clockwise from the signer. Alright, so we talked about the five characteristics of hands. The first is the shape, whether it's an A shape, a B shape, a C shape, or any other one of 261 shapes. The second one is handedness, whether it's my right hand or my left hand. The third one is plane, whether it's parallel to the wall or parallel to the floor. The fourth one is facing, whether it's facing you, the side, or me. And the last one is rotation, whether the hand is 90 degrees, or perhaps maybe it's rotated that way or this way. Now, having all these features, we can use the SignWriting font to calculate what character we need in every situation. But how do we code that? First, we have handshape. We'll keep that for later. Second, we have the handedness. Holistic, Media Pipe Holistic, actually gives us the handedness already. We know what is the right hand and what is the left hand, so that's saved from us. The third one is plane, whether it's parallel to the wall or to the floor. For that, I had a really, really simple heuristic. My heuristic goes as follows. We take this part of the hand from the wrist until this joint. If this is higher on the y-axis rather than deeper on the z-axis, that means that it's a wall plane, and otherwise, it's a floor plane. The fourth one is facing, whether it's facing outwards, inwards, or to the side. We don't actually have a limb to actually tell us where it's facing, so instead, I'm taking the norm of the hand plane. So if we have a plane coming from the wrist, this point on the index, and this point on the pinky, we have kind of a triangle, we can take the normal, which points outwards from this plane,
and asked kind of a similar question to before. If the angle is between, let's say, 0 degrees and 60 degrees, then it's facing outwards. If it's between 60 degrees and 120 degrees, it's facing to the side. And if it's between 120 degrees and upwards, it's facing to me. Lastly, for the fifth characteristic, rotation, that's as simple as taking that limb again and just calculating its XY angle on screen so we can see what's the angle. But sign writing doesn't support all possible angles. Instead, they divide the circle into 8 equal pieces, where all 8 pieces are possible, and any rotation inside a piece is just normalized to that piece's ID. Let's see this in action.
Alright, we're still drawing the same things as before, but now I changed the hand from being the fist to being this shape. It's constant this shape right now, so even if I change my hand shape, it's just this shape for now. Next step is to look at all the other characteristics. So we have two hands, handedness. Left hand shows this sign and right hand shows this sign. It's like a mirror image. Maybe I should turn off the video and close so one can see. And if the hands are parallel to the wall, this is the sign. If the hands are parallel to the floor, maybe it's something more like this with a line inside. It's going a bit crazy, but that's the idea at least. If we have the hand and we're rotating it, then we're seeing the rotation applied to the shape, and then we also have facing. So right now the hands are facing outwards. If I face to the side, then this is what you see, and if I face inwards, this is the shape. So this works kind of well when this is parallel to the wall plane, and not so well when it's parallel to the floor plane. Actually, MediaPipe, the pose estimation system, kind of freaks out. Let's see just the pose. So this is the wall plane. It looks kind of great. And if I am parallel to the floor plane, you can see it's either not recognizing or the hand is just a bit going crazy. Even the other way around, it's not as nice as just the wall plane right now. But we're assuming we have a perfect 3D pose estimation system at some point. So building these rules would just generalize at some point. That's the hope at least. In the next video, we'll work on hand shapes to understand whether this is an A, a B, a C, or any one out of 261 hand shapes available in sign writing. If you have any questions, comment below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.